I feel like everyone does those intros where they just randomly walk into the camera and make that into an intro. Well, that's gonna be our intro as well. Let me make myself a little bit more comfortable. So welcome back, everyone. As you can see, I kind of did a little bit of a scene change, even though the weather is still like kind of gloomy out, so I have to have my ring light for props. I hope everyone's good. Everyone's chilling. Let me see if I can do my hair back. Yeah, that's better. So, I hope you all liked my last video, and I think from now on, I'm going to start doing like little series. And I think series as in like series of me living in Turkey and different topics that I can talk about while living here. And then I just had this idea like a couple of days ago to talk about this topic, and I did a little bit of research online, and I saw a lot of people did a lot of videos on this, and I saw like a lot of articles as well. So everyone has their own opinion, obviously, and I do respect everyone's opinion, and especially those who like foreigners who move to Turkey and so on and so forth. So today what I'm going to talk about is I found an article or a blog where it's like 8 useful things to know before moving to Turkey, and I'll link the blog down below. And it's just a random blog that I just found while I was just searching on Google, and I kind of wanted to go like through it and see if it's actually true or not. And it's updated, so. And then I thought that it could help with anyone trying to move to Turkey in an updated version. I did have my own considerations, like I made a list of them, but then again I was looking at everyone else's videos and stories and stuff, and I feel like it's the same kind of thing. So I thought that maybe I, as someone who is kind of also Turkish and a foreigner, I can explain why like some things are like that and some foreigners may not understand why it's like this. I mean, I remember I saw one girl, she was talking about how Turkish people love to use like a lot of gestures, like hand gestures, which is very true. Like you can even tell, like I'm just always out and like my hands are always out there, but it's just how we talk. And I think that since the country with all these foreigners, you have to like talk with your hands as well. I don't know, but so we're gonna go ahead and get started, and maybe I'll do a part 2 if anyone actually wants like more, and if anyone's interested. I'm going on my iPad because I'm using my phone to record, so it's the best thing I have right now. So number one on the list is that they say that it's really hot in Turkey. Yes, it does get really, really hot in Turkey. Not as much as cold, like it doesn't get as cold anymore, even though I've only seen three winters already in Turkey, and I can say DC winter is a lot worse, maybe because of global warming, climate change, I don't know. But Turkey's winter, as I saw in the movies and you know back in the old day, it's not how it used to be. I think we saw snow last year, like during February, March, and but like I hear from people, they say that there's no, like it's not the snow how we used to see it. Whereas my mom back in Maryland is saying like they have a snowstorm coming. So, but going back to hotness, yes, in summertime, starting from like end of May, mid-June, all the way up until like September, it does get really, really hot. Even though it's not like icky, well, it kind of is. I don't know how to explain it. Like I also seen summer in different countries, like in America, but in America we're so used to like air conditioning in the cars and stuff like that, we're not worried about it. But here you walk a lot more, you not a lot of houses now, they tend to have a lot more like air conditioning. I know we just had one in put our house like when I first moved here, but it does get really hot. But also when it does get hot, people go to the beaches and go to Bodrum and go to places to cool down. So that's, it's nice, but it's also, it can be stressful for anyone who doesn't like the heat, so keep that in mind. Number two on the list, it says Turks eat seasonally. It says, yeah, actually, yeah, I would have to agree with this only because I didn't know this, but when I was back in the States, you know, whatever my parents made, whatever we would eat, like we would just have. I mean, yeah, there's things that you can eat seasonally, that you can eat in the summer, like watermelon. You can't really find it in the wintertime. Like everyone knows that. But when I moved to Turkey, it's a lot more serious. I remember like a month ago, I was making stuffed bell peppers with like rice. And I was like, my mother-in-law called me and she was like, oh, what are you making? Typical mother-in-law thing, Turkish mother-in-law thing. And I was like, oh, like stuffed, like dolma biberleri falan. And she goes, like, it's not the season. And she goes, why are you making it? It's not seasonal. And I'm like, I didn't know that was a thing. I just, you know, I like them and I saw them at the bazaar and I just got some and I decided to make them. But it is true when it says that food are seasonal. And I think that's the best thing about Turkey because you get introduced to so many new foods and fruits and vegetables and everything. There's so many things I've have never seen in my life, even though I do come from a Turkish family, that I have seen in Turkey, and it's like it brings out the best in food taste and everything. So I do have to agree with that one. And the tomatoes, they're a lot more like natural and not less processed, as anyone who lives in the States knows, everything is processed there. Okay, so number three on the list is, it says put yourself out there. And I think this is goes for those who are kind of foreigners and are looking, who are more outspoken, or like who like to go out and meet new people and try new things, which is good. Since I had family here and I had friends prior, I already kind of made that friend group. But also during my master's like program and stuff, I did make a lot of new friends as well. But I do have to agree with this, and I think it depends on like who you are as a person. Some people don't, they just want to kind of travel on their own and whatever, that's totally fine. But I feel like if you are someone who's very, you know, outgoing and want to make new friends, this is very true. And in Turkey, I feel like that's very easy because there's so many people from different parts of the world living here. And it's really, really convenient just to like make a Facebook group safely, obviously in crowded spots to meet up. And you know, even try out like a language class to meet new people. I think that's the best place to meet new people. And then I think after that, you'll tend to put yourself more out there and meet new people and so on and so forth. But yeah. Four on the item, it says don't underestimate the cultural differences. Yes, especially for Turkey, don't be appalled when you see a wedding in the middle of the street. And you know, I don't know how it is nowadays, but when I used to come with my family out for like vacation, we would be sitting in, you know, our living room and my aunt's house. And all of a sudden we hear like a wedding in the middle of the street, like, you know, mahalle düğünü, that's how they say it. I keep like forgetting the name. And my aunt was like, oh, let's just get up and go and see what's going, like what's happening. And we got up and we went, and they were so welcoming. Oh my God. I mean, if someone did that to my wedding, I would not have them come inside. But especially when they know that you're foreigners, they love that. They love like having people experience the different cultures, and you'll like the cultural differences here. And when you move to Turkey, or if you ever come and visit Turkey, you'll definitely see this as well because it's everywhere. If you say to someone, I've never had Turkish coffee out in the house, they'll give you the whole like Turkish coffee to you just so you can experience it. And it's just how it is there. People are very like welcoming. And there's just so much cultural. It's like a cultural shock here. When it comes to weddings, like I said, birthday, oh, not as much birthdays, but mostly weddings. And when it comes to like different holidays, there's always something to do. And there's a lot of like events and football games, when it comes like Galatasaray, Fenerbahce, Besiktas, much like games, everyone tends to team up, like gather up somewhere, and they kind of just celebrate, drink, or do whatever, yell, scream, and then go to the game. Oh, and another example that I personally think it's just so important, I mean, on Onun Kasım, which is November 10th, is when Mustafa Kemal Atatürk passed away. And on that day and at that time where he passed away, everyone kind of gathers up at Dolmabahçe, which is where he passed. Or if they're on the street, anywhere in Turkey, at exactly 9:05 a.m., everything stops, sirens go like, go everywhere around the country. And everyone stops what they're doing, and they just kind of take a moment of silence to remember him. And I think that, like, when I first experienced that in Turkey, I still get like chills. But it's such an important thing, and I think that's like dearest to me, and that just shows you how we tend to take our cultural and holidays like very important. Number five, it says give it time. Yes, give it time. I think this was like number one thing on my list as well, because even not in Turkey, but when you're moving abroad, especially from for example, I'm taking myself as an example, and I moved from the US to Turkey, it was one bit easier for me, even though I still had struggles, even though I knew the country, I knew the language, I had family and friends here. It does take time. There are a lot of things here that are not, it might not be the same as where you're coming from when it comes to the system, or just getting like your permit, your resident permit, or your license permit, whatever the case may be. It will take maybe two or three more steps for you to do to get that, and it can be stressful. I'm telling you, especially if you're someone who doesn't really know the language, it's very, very, it can be challenging. So I think that's why having a friend, having a family member maybe here already, helping you along the way could be beneficial. And it does take time. You can be homesick. I mean, I know I was really homesick, and especially like because of the pandemic, I wasn't able to travel before, and that really was horrible. But now, you know, we have FaceTime, we have stuff that, you know, Zoom, I don't know what it's called anymore, but there's a lot of things out there that help us more closer to our family and friends back home. So I think that's good too. But it is, I would say this one, give it time, is very, very true. You can't expect everything overnight, and especially in a country where things might be a little bit more harder to get, like I mentioned before. You have to be patient. Be very, very, very patient. If you're not patient with people in Turkey, with the system in Turkey, it can override and it just won't be pretty, and you'll get more frustrated, and you'll end up not expecting your time here as it should be. I don't know how to explain it, but give it time. That's very true. Okay, number six is very true, but I've also experienced this coming from a household of like a Turkish mother. Tidy everything up at home. Yes. I think I was always a clean person. My mom was always a very clean and organized, like my whole family was. My dad, my brother, everyone. And I'm actually very lucky that my husband's very organized too. For a guy, not you know, no offense, but sometimes it gets harder living with a guy, or you know, your partner, it could be very hard. But thankfully he's also very clean and organized too. But in Turkey, I think this, I could take this into consideration but pre-COVID times, but everything, and this goes for like, how do I explain it, when it comes to, and it, if you look at the article, it's kind of explains everything I'm going to explain now. When it comes to your bills and everything, make sure everything is organized, because all the bills come to you at once, and this might not change. You might be like this person back home before you moved, but abroad it might be different. So I've gotten used to paying the bills like, because they all are kind of due around the same time period. But before like COVID, you would technically have a lot of people, I guess, coming over to your house. So that's why everything always had to be clean. And now that it's COVID, not a lot of people go to people's houses as often anymore. But I do have to say, it's very true. Me moving to Turkey really, really did make me a lot more like, more clean, even though I was always a clean person. I make sure like my house is always tidy, my bathroom, my kitchen, more importantly. Because you never know who's gonna come, who's gonna call and be like, oh, çayı koy ben yiyorum. Like, you never know, really. So I think that's very true. And I think that's a good thing. It's not a bad thing. But this doesn't go for anyone, everyone as well in Turkey. But from what I know, a lot of the houses in Turkey are very, very clean and they're always tidy. So, but if you do move to Turkey, keep that into consideration. And it might be useful for you if you're not someone who is clean, which is okay. Everyone has their own ways. Number seven, consider buying goods in Turkey. Yeah. You can always, I mean, Turkey is a place where like a lot of buyers buy their products. It's a lot less and it comes in a lot more bulk and the quality is a lot better. I mean, if you've been to Eminönü, Kapalıçarşı, you already know what I'm talking about. And I know a lot of people who do business here, sending it to like Ukraine, Russia, USA, and everything and like goods and stuff. So, oh wait, they're not talking about that. Oh, I'm sorry. That's also something to consider, but I think they're talking about buying new furniture here. That also depends. Are moving like starting something fresh in Turkey, with an apartment and so on and so forth. I don't know what the situation might be for you if you just want to completely permanently move here, and that for a case like you would have to bring your furniture all from Turkey to here and pay tax and such and so on and so forth. And this person was like, I wish I bought furniture in Turkey. Yes, if you are able to have the money and if you are able to afford it, that's way better of a choice. I'd rather if I didn't have any furniture, but if I did, I would sell them back home and use that money to buy a whole bunch of new furniture here because it's gonna be a lot cheaper, especially now with the dollar going up. It's gonna be a lot cheaper and you get to kind of start fresh. And the furniture here, I'm telling y'all, it's great. I mean, it's expensive now for a lot of people, because like I said, because of the economy, but it's more affordable than bringing your furniture back from just let's say the States here because of the taxes and so on and so forth, the fees. So it's way better to just sell them back home and buy a whole bunch of new stuff here. Because if you also buy from like secondhand spots, then it's even cheaper. And like I said, the goods here are a lot better, quality wise, and a lot more cheaper when you're paying in foreign exchange. I don't know, but I do have to agree with that as well. Number eight and last is like, no, you won't take it all for granted. Yes. Personally, I went back to the States last April to visit my family, and that was like after a year of not traveling at all. And I literally, at like the sec towards the end of my trip, I called my husband. I was like, I cannot wait to come home. Because even though what anyone else will say, people always tell me, like, oh, people are trying to leave this country. Why are you like, why did you come here? I think that's a very all like personal opinion type of thing. For someone who I'm very grateful that I'm able to go from Turkey to the US like back and forth. Something just fell, but whatever. But I do have to say, like, I don't know if it's the water, if it's the food, I don't know what it is, but this place, when you stand like when you end up coming here and you're living here for a while, you understand like there's very, very good like parts about this country. Especially like even though it's kind of going through rough times, and not just this, I mean, the whole world is kind of going through a lot of like rough moments, but I am able to walk out of this house, like my apartment, and go take a walk by the Bosphorus. I don't think a lot of people understand how that's like amazing, and it's a really good like chance And especially for anyone who's like foreigner, yes, it's a lot better. But I also understand where people are coming from if they live here and like because they might not have moved to a different country, they don't understand. But I do think that living here has made me realize that like I am very lucky, because Turkey is a beautiful country. Whoops. And yeah, once you move here, you realize it's like a love or hate relationship. I don't know how to explain it again, but either you do everything, you go through all the hardship, you get everything done, and then you take a deep breath and you're like, okay, I can enjoy my moment in Turkey. Or you try it, it just doesn't work, and you just end up going back, which is fine too. But I think that when you're able to settle in Turkey, in Istanbul especially, it can be hectic, it can be stressful, it can be like chaotic, but it's worth it. Like I don't regret anything. And if I will stay here, if I won't stay here, that's totally up to me and my family. But I can say that if I were to move, I would definitely miss this country a lot. But sometimes you have to think about your future when it comes to stuff like that. But that's a story for a different day. But yeah, that's all. And I think they did a pretty good job. There are obviously more stuff to this, and more things to consider while moving or before moving to Turkey or while you're living here to consider. But like I said, I've seen so many like videos and articles, and I thought this would kind of more like more common sense. And it's kind of cultural. Whereas like I said, I can go into more details about other things, but there's a lot of videos for that, and I don't know about them, like how to get a permit and blah blah blah. So you can definitely check those out too, but let me know what you guys think. If you are living in Turkey, if you are considering to live in Turkey, what do you think? And do you have any more ideas that I should make for a part two? Let me know, comment down below, and maybe I'll do another video for that. But yeah, nonetheless, Turkey is a beautiful place to live. Like I said, stressful, it can be hard, but at the end of the day, the water, the Bosphorus, the smell of it, you won't be able to find anywhere else. But yeah, well, thank you all for watching. Again, subscribe and let me know if you have any ideas for my next video. All right, guys, see you next time.